Hi everybody, this is Nick and welcome back to my channel. Today I wanted to give you a little bit of a tip when you're working with maps or actually any object or any chart inside of Excel. Now there's a little bit of a trick here. Right here I have a Washington state map here of all of the zip codes that I made in Excel. You can see where when I click on the chart, this is a filled map chart in Excel, you can see where my source data are pulling from, the state Washington, and then there's the zip code, and then this is the value column right here shaded in blue. So you can see I have this really nice heat map right here. But what if I wanted to filter this map a little bit? This is something interesting that kind of happens. Maybe I just want to filter it so that I'm showing just these first five zip codes or these first five cities right here. So I'm going to push OK. Now look what happens. Oh my gosh, my map shrinks. Why is that? Because the map properties are not set up properly to keep the map sort of intact when you are filtering your data source range. So let's go ahead and pick, look under the hood just a little bit. I'm going to go ahead and select all of these so that we get our map back. Here's our map. Now, if I select the map, we're going to go ahead and right click and say format chart area. And then we're going to go over to the format chart area menu right here. Let's go ahead and click on the size and property button right here. Now there's two little drop-down menus right here. This is the size button. You could go ahead and play with the size dimensions of your chart if you wanted to. But then down here under properties, you can see it's defaulted to move and size with cells. That's why anytime I hide cells or rows or I delete cells or rows that are in the way of this map, that map is going to shrink and things are going to go haywire. So let's go ahead and say don't move or size with cells. You could also say move, but don't size with cells. So that might actually move it over or keep it in that little cell range. You could do either one and kind of experiment and just try what you like there. We're going to say print object, and we're going to just keep this locked. If I go ahead and hover over this, it says locking objects has no effect unless the sheet is protected. So if you had like a dashboard or something in Excel and you had all these charts and you wanted them to stay in place, make sure to click that locked button and then protect the sheet so nobody can move those around. Little pro tip there. Okay, now since I've already updated those properties, let's go ahead and do that same filter over here to the first five cities in my list. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and there, 1, 2, 3, 4, oops, one more. And I'm gonna go ahead and click okay. And now you can see that the map stays intact, but my data, I'm actually drilling down a little bit because now the source range has kind of shrunken right there. So all I'm seeing now are those zip codes that I actually filtered from those from that city list. So that's pretty cool. So make sure that when you have these maps, if you have sort of a dynamic range that they're filtering from, or you're just using these filter buttons to go ahead and filter the source data, that you go back over here to that format chart area menu, click on the properties and make sure you click don't move or size with cells. That's good for any chart, any kind of object or text box that you put inside of your Word document. So a little bit of a pro tip. If you like this video, give it a thumbs up and make sure to hit the subscribe button and the bell next to it. You'll get notified every time I post a new video in data design, usually PowerPoint, Excel, or Word. I had a great time making this for you and can't wait to see you next time.